Hi kids, my name is Shraddha Kameshwar and I am a biotechnologist. So today we'll be looking at a fun English level 3 story called The Auto That Flew, written by Ken Spillman and illustrated by Ajanta Guhathakurta. Caught in the mad traffic of Delhi, an auto feels a touch of magic. So let's take a ride with the driver and the passenger and feel the feather touch of a little stardust. Arjun had three wheels, one headlight, and a coat of green and yellow. He belonged to the largest family in the whole of Delhi. Everywhere Arjun went, there were brothers, sisters, aunties, uncles, and cousins. "Go carefully," they beeped. "Sure," he would beep in reply. Arjun worked hard day and night. "Fut, fut, tuka, tuka, tuk," he went. Fut fut tuka tuka tuk. He never complained because auto wala Shirish worked hard too. Shirishji had old bones that caused him pain. He decorated Arjun's dashboard with plastic flowers and pictures of movie stars. He quenched Arjun's thirst for clean gas, even when the queues were long. And whenever Arjun's canopy was torn, he wasted no time in taking it to be patched. Arjun liked taking whole families to Lajpat Nagar market. His heart sang when tourists chose three wheels over four. He loved to rest with Shirishji in the shade of a tree outside Qutub Minar. Arjun never got tired of the glamour of Connaught Place at night. He was thrilled by the bustle outside the railway station and by the crowds that spewed from Feroz Shah Kotla after a cricket match. Life was good and Arjun knew he should never wish for more. But secretly, Arjun did wish for more. Secretly, he wanted to fly. Oh, to have helicopter blades, Arjun thought. They would chop the air above his canopy. Shirishji would wrap his head in a scarf and the ends of it would flap gaily in the breeze. Off they would go, fut fut tuka tuka tuk in the sky. But Arjun knew this was only a dream. An auto having helicopter blades would be like an elephant having wings, or a train that could zoom off into space like a rocket with its carriages trailing behind. One hot day, Arjun was waiting in a hot spot of traffic at a busy intersection. Behind Shirishji sat a grey-haired woman in a dull, well-worn sari. Fut, fut, fut. A grubby boy came squeezing between cars and autos, selling water. His eyes sparkled like polished stones as he held out one frosted bottle. "Ma'am, very cold, very good, magic." The woman laughed. "Magic?" The boy wobbled his head with such gusto that Arjun thought it might fall off. "We all need a little magic," the woman said. She produced some rupees and took two bottles from the boy. Immediately, she handed one to Shirishji. Shirishji smiled broadly, showing the woman his pan-stained teeth. He drank quickly and the traffic budged. "Already the magic is working," Shirishji joked. The woman drank too, spilling a little on Arjun as he started forward. "Fut fut tuka tuka tuk," went Arjun, beeping a cheery hello to one of his brothers. No sooner were they moving than Arjun began to feel light on his wheels. The traffic parted before him and he sailed through. Astonished by the open road, Shirishji caught the woman's eye in his rear view mirror. "Yes, very magical, ma'am." Now the woman's sari carried a brilliant sheen. and was embroidered with fine gold thread. Magic, she chuckled. Arjun's wheel lifted off the road. Up, up, up he went. Fat, fat, tuka, tuka, tuk, up, up, up. There were no helicopter blades to help him. Magic, Arjun thought. It's auto magic. A flock of birds scattered. Arjun's headlight was lit with joy. Arjun flew high above Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium and India Gate. He looked upon Humayun's tomb and the Yamuna River and the gracious temple of the Akshardham. He saw a giant web of roads like the work of a crazy spider. Wide-eyed, Shirishji began shrieking with the fun of it all. He no longer gripped the handlebar, no longer dodged cars. The woman fingered her beautiful sari. Sir, she called, looking at the rear view mirror. Your face! When Shirishji looked at himself, he saw a face like that of a Bollywood hero. His teeth shone white and his skin was radiant. He must drink more water, he roared. But what are we doing? Arjun wondered. Where can we go? What am I if I am no longer driven? Never had Arjun been so free, yet never had he felt so lost. In the world he had known, every journey had purpose. Every destination was temporary. In boundless quiet above all the honking cars, Arjun missed the roads of his life, jammed with cars, motorcycles and buses. Below he saw his friends at work, dots of yellow canopy glowing bright like beacons. Arjun even missed the rush and bustle of people, all so eager to arrive somewhere else. Places to go, places to go. Fat, fat, tuka, tuka, tuk. The woman looked down and thought of the joys below. It was easy now to forget the shimmer of her sari. I was going to visit my daughter and grandchildren, she thought. They will be waiting. They are the real magic in my life. Already Shirishji was tired of his Bollywood face. What use is it? He wondered. Once he had wished only for this. Now Shirishji wanted only the comfort of his own skin. Arjun's headlight had grown dull. He felt aimless. He could read Shirishji's thoughts. He could sense the woman's moods. Lower and lower he flew. The city radiated warmth. The nearer Arjun got, the more energy it gave him. Shirishji became busy again, drinking in the familiar magic of the city. Every sign and every turning spoke to him. Very soon he could recognize himself again. He knew where he was going. He was already there. The woman's sari became dull, but her face was bright. Down to earth they came. Arjun's wheels touched warm asphalt and his engine sighed with relief. Fat fat taka taka tu. Go carefully, beeped a brother from the street corner. The woman's grandchildren waved from a window above. She stepped down and handed Shirishji her fare. Auto, auto, auto. Arjun heard the wonderful cry of a stranger. Every ride would be new, part of his endless journey full of surprises. Okay kid, that's all. Hope you had a great time. Bye, take care.